Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this Photoshop Elements Remove Background video, we'll be taking out this grassy background back here, removing it out of the picture, and that will allow us to come in and give this picture a different background, just like that. That easy to do. Okay, now if you enjoy this video, make sure that you subscribe to my channel and also click that like button. If you want to learn everything about Photoshop Elements, then take a look at my complete training, and you'll find a link for that in the description. Okay, let's get to it. To remove and replace the background in a Photoshop Elements picture, it's really a pretty simple concept. What you need to do is to make a selection around your object and use that selection to create a layer mask, which we see right up here. Once you have your layer mask in place, you can then use that to hide the background around your object and then put something else in behind, which becomes your new background. Now, the choice of what tool to use to make that selection is the real key to making a quality selection. Now, if you have a hard edge, I normally will go over here and I'll use the polygonal lasso tool, which is right down there. If I have a softer edge, like I have in here with some hair and so forth, then I'll usually come in and use the regular lasso tool to make a rough selection and then clean that selection up using the refine edge tool. And that's how we'll take a look and fix this particular problem here. Okay, let's just get rid of this one. Get that out of the way. There we go. And here's our basic dog picture. So, two basic steps. First, make a loose selection, and then second, clean that selection up using the refine edge tool. So here's the basic tool, lasso tool, and we're working with a new selection here. In this instance, I have feathering set at 0 because I'm using the refine edge anyway. It's going to be giving me a soft edge anyway, so that doesn't need to be set any higher than 0 for this. Now you can zoom in. When you're doing this, might be a bit easier. Let's go to our zoom tool and let's just zoom in a few clicks. There we go. And now I'll use this tool, start outside, and I'll just come along and stay in fairly close. I don't want to go into the dog at all, but I want to be fairly close to the dog. Now when you come up to an edge like this, if you go up against it with this tool, the picture will scroll, but it's better if you hold the space bar down and then pull the picture, let go of the space bar, and then continue your selection just like that. So set us a little ways out. Don't go up right up against the dog. We'll get that fine edge with the refine edge tool. And again, space bar, and pull the picture, and then just kind of continue on around. Now this basic technique has uses in lots of pictures, and you will see me use this in a lot of my videos. It's really kind of a real basic thing that once you have this concept down, it can really help you out in all kinds of images. Now notice right down here, I cut into the dog a little bit right there. Let's just fix that. I want to add that to my selection, so go here to add, and I'll just do a little loop around that, and that adds that in. Okay, that's taken care of. Now, let's go up to our select and refine edge. Now right now, I'm working in Photoshop Elements 15. If you're in a different version, the refine edge should look relatively similar in 14 and 13. If you don't have refine edge, then you have to do it the hard way, which is just using the regular or the polygonal lasso tool and just making a lot of little points along the edge. You can do it, but it's just a lot more work. Now when you're in the refine edge, you'll be using this tool here. This is the radius tool, and I like using the overlay color option in here. You also can hold the space bar down. As you can see there, you can hold the space bar down and you can move the picture around with that space bar while still keeping the tool. Now when I use this, I'll take this kind of crosshair that's in that. Here's the size of your brush. I'll leave this at 35. That's the default. And I'm going to go over right up against that edge right there where that line is, the line of my initial selection. Now if I come right down and hit the edge of the dog, that's fine. If I don't, I'm not going to worry about it yet. I'll normally do a couple of passes on this. That's my first pass. I'll then see if I came down to the edge. If I did, great. If I didn't, I'll just do a little bit of an additional push just like that. Okay, hold the space bar down one more time. Let's just move the dog over here. I'm going to put this a little further over there. There we are. And again, same thing. I'm going right up against the edge of my initial selection. And as you can see, I'm probably coming right down against the edge of that dog anyway, which is fine. And that's what I want to be doing. There we go. Let it think for a minute. Okay, it's a little bit rough here, so I'll just come over this section. Easy to see here because I have that green color in behind, so it makes it real easy to see where it's not quite matching, like a little bit right in there. And then just continue around and work it this way again, going over that edge that I had, and then if I need to, I can come back in a little bit closer and get the edge of the dog. So normally work out and work towards the dog on a couple of passes, or work towards your subject. That's the best way to do this. Okay, now we have that. Let's go to our zoom tool here, right here in the refine edge. I'm going to zoom in a bit further and back to my tool. And using the space bar, I'm just going to pull straight along and look for any little spots that have a bit of green in them on the edge. Just kind of really clean up that edge. We should be okay. Like right there, there's a little bit right there. There we go, just a little touch-up, clean-up on that edge. Again, this is real easy this time because I have that sharp, distinct color in the background. Now, for the refined edge to work, you need to either have a sharp color difference or you need to have a sharp contrast difference. In this case, we had color, which is absolutely perfect for us. Makes it real easy to do this. Now, again, if you don't have a definite difference between your background and your foreground, if they're very, very similar, you're going to have to use a lasso tool instead. And again, if you have this kind of fur stuff, it makes it much, much more difficult. So hopefully you have that distinction in there so you can do this. I have found pictures where I just cannot do them, can't select them any way here inside of Photoshop Elements, no matter what I try. I've tried a lot. I'll show you one of those in just a bit here. Let's go back on to fit screen. So there's our selection. There's the overlay. Now if I change this to on black, you can see that. And if I change this over here to on white, we can see that. There's a little bit of stuff right down along here. You can kind of see that down there and right up in here. So let's zoom in and we'll see if we can clean up that edge any more. Just a little bit along there. The first thing I'll try here is to increase my contrast a little bit. Sometimes increasing contrast will clean that stuff out, and actually it did there. That kind of cleaned out that bit of a mess in there, and that's fine. Looks good. Now if you get little spots like that, just go ahead and hit them again with this tool. It'll look a little weird because we're doing this on white background. What we're seeing there, that's the picture in behind, and then we see the mask effect when I let go. Okay, so I just have the space bar held down again, and I'm just double checking my edges. And the reason you get a little bit of that color showing through there is because we're actually seeing a little bit of that background through, because what this does for us is gives you a very, very slight transparency in there. When we add the layer mask onto that, that green effect will go away. You'll just get a little transparency. We'll put something else in behind and it will look real nice. Okay, so there you go. You can do a little bit of cleanup down here. Normally I'll just use the contrast. A little bit more contrast tends to clean up the edges real nice. Okay, once you have your edge done and you check that against your black, looks fine, and against your white, looks fine. And I'll put it back to my overlay. There we go. And then come down here, it says output and output 2, and you may want to do decontaminate colors in there. That just helps a little bit on that edge. And then I want to go to a layer mask. See, here we have new layer with layer mask right there. Click on that one and choose OK. And there it is. So what that does is it keeps our original and gives us a new layer right here with our layer mask on that. All right, let's now zoom out. I'll fit on screen again. There we go. So a nice cleaned up dog picture. There's our transparency. So we've removed that background in there from the dog. Let's now put in a new background file, and I have one hiding in here. Here it is. Hayden Valley, kind of pretty valley image. I'll just drag this in, get rid of that, and then I'll pull the sides out to resize this just a bit so it fits properly. There we go. and then I'll drag that down underneath of my dog picture, and there we go. There's the dog in a new background. Just that easy to do. We removed the background with the lasso tool and then the refine edge, and then replaced it by putting another picture in behind the dog. Okay, again, real easy to do, but it's a great technique to really practice on and learn well, because you'll find a million uses for this in all kinds of projects. Let me show you one picture where I mentioned you just really can't fix. Here we go. I have tried to mask this out numerous times. I tried it here, I tried it in Photoshop. I have never had any luck on this because there's just some weird stuff happening. Up here the hair is light, over here the hair is dark. In here the background's dark, and here the background's light. So there's the background and the foreground are different across the image. There's a lot of this little fine stuff in here. Now if you go over to the professional Photoshop, Adobe Photoshop program, and you really play around with channels and things, there are ways of doing this kind of level of background removal, but you just cannot do this in Elements. This is beyond what Elements can do. So if you see something like this, if you have a project like this, picture like this, and all you have is Elements, just put it aside, figure you can't do that, it's not going to work. Hopefully it has something with a bit more contained edge, like we have here with our dog, and then it's a fairly easy process, as you saw, to go ahead and remove that background and then replace it with something else. So there you go. That's how you can use Photoshop Elements to remove a background. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com.